Oil prices soared again this week to highs we haven't seen in 2.5 years. Gas prices continue to follow. Oil's hovering around that $100 a barrel mark. The spike comes as violence escalates in Libya, spreading concerns about further disruptions to oil in the region. There have actually been very few disruptions to oil at all. Christy, at what point does the unrest in the Middle East and North Africa send oil and gas prices to highs that could actually start to threaten this very fragile recovery that we've got going on around the world?
At this point now.
I think
the oil price is already, you know, the recovery, as you said, Ali, is fragile, and this is really going to be a shock for America. I think it shows yet again that postponing problems does not solve them. If America had imposed a higher gas tax when oil prices were lower, the country would be in a much better place to deal with this.
All right, the average price for a gallon of gas this week, by the way, shooting up, topping $3.45 a gallon. But we've heard from people across the country. We've got pictures. Our cameramen have pictures of gas above $4. Joe, the downside to $4 a gallon gas and rising energy prices, that's obvious. We pay more. But rising energy prices are the only way, according to some people, that we are actually going to lower our dependence on imported oil.
Make up your mind for once and for all. Every 6 months we go through this. Every time the price of gas goes up, we say we're going to get serious about energy efficiency.
Right.
We're going to go up to Canada and we're going to get all that stuff, the shale and everything like that. Then the prices go down and we completely forget it. Make up your mind what you're going to do once and for all. Once the price gets about $100, then we start doing the research down, you know, below our basements looking for oil.
Absolutely.
And then they lower the prices. And it's a trick. They get to 101, we get serious, they lower the prices. We have to get serious once and for all or stop having the conversation.
I'm curious as to where you fit into this, Stephen, on oil and energy prices.
Well, look, I think the higher oil prices and higher prices when you pump at the gasoline pump, those are like a tax on the American consumer. So there's no question, Ali, that's going to hurt this recovery. The good news is we got a great jobs number this weekend, so I think we're seeing a big pickup there. But look, I've been saying for 25 years, let's be drilling. Let's drill for all of our natural resources that we have in the United States. We should be drilling in Alaska. We should be drilling offshore.
But it's not enough. Bottom line, it's still not enough. It's not enough. I mean, we are not increasing the price of oil in America. It's China and it's India where they're, you know, our demand is flat. It has been for a long time in the United States.
Ali, you know, okay, let's talk about natural gas.
Right.
We are finding so much natural gas. I'm convinced natural gas is the fuel of the future.
Right, so is Boone Pickens, but we're not doing anything about
natural gas.
You're right, but we're not really doing anything. We consume 10% of the world's oil.
We got to get at that natural gas because that could be a substitute for oil.
All right, Stephen, what can the Republicans do right now to make sure that voters don't add rising gas and energy prices to their list of grievances?
They're going to. There's no question about that. This is something that hits every one of us at the pocketbook. And by the way, it's not just gasoline prices. You saw what happened last week with food prices. Those are rising. $3.50 for a box of Cheerios now. We're seeing that, by the way. Airlines just declared this week they're going to raise their prices. So I'm worried about inflation, Ali, and that's a tax on American consumers.
Joe, is this an ivory tower conversation we're having? I mean, are people out there thinking there's a recovery? Are they thinking that the economy sucks? What's going on?
The economy sucks. I personally am willing to spend 20 cents extra for Cheerios if it will get rid of people like Gaddafi, but I don't drive far and I take public transportation. If you're out in the Midwest, if you're out in the West and you drive a lot, you're feeling this now, and you're definitely not feeling the recovery. If you've got kids who have never even seen what a job looks like, you don't believe that this recovery has taken root.